that's me punching above my weight, that's my wife. She grabbed some rub-on and bought that, just wanted to see what the effect was. People use the rub-ons for pain, but also for different types of eczema. And they all seem to get it out with chopsticks. It seems to be the flavor of the month over there. This is another one in Vancouver. Looking nice and clean. And that guy wearing his helmet inside looks good. And this is what the shatter comes out and looks like. That costs $80. Very potent. That would probably would last a patient a month. That's me at Whistler Cannabis Company, one of the certified companies in Canada. Canada has strict regulations on production, on quality of product that comes out. Every batch has to be tested. Testing costs money to test for toxins, potentially from contaminants, and then for the levels of THC and CBD. The level of paperwork over there is just about at Australian level, it's very high. So just to rehash, sorry, I've been waiting to say that all day. The prescription is very easy. It's patient titration. The CBD, you can give packet loads of it and you'll find no side effects. The THC is what you want to, if you have to give THC or you want to give THC, then you need to get the patient to know the product and then to titrate to their effect.
So what are the implications for employment in particularly virus industry?
Exactly. A bit of a controversy, huh? For the THC, because that's essentially what they test for, to get out of your body depends on what sort of test they will do. Generally, it's a urine test, so they need to be clear of using the cannabis for at least 2 weeks. If it's someone that's a heavy user, it could be 2 months.
So that's THC, or
that's THC.
THC.
All they'll test for is THC. They won't test for cannabidiol. The tests that are done, urine tests, are for THC alone.
Okay, so they won't pick up the other cannabinoids.
No, just for the THC. So if someone's on CBD oil, etc., they won't test positive. It's just the THC. Questions? Back.
What about tolerance? Do they just continue titrating up
there
themselves?
Yeah, the tolerance studies have been done. And it's not like opiates would require more and more and more. In fact, there will be a little bit of tolerance over about 2 weeks to a month, and then they'll stay at a standard dose. So that'll be then, which is fantastic. Any other questions at all?
What about elite athletes? Any movement there? I mean,
2 years ago it was taken away from off the WADA testing.
Yeah.
They found it wasn't performance enhancing, although some people do like to train and run and do whatever on it.
Yeah.
But they took it off. I think it was too much. What's the word? Effort for them.
Yeah.
Michael Phelps was positive. Who else?
Yeah. Usain Bolt.
Yeah. Yes. There are cannabinoid mimics out there. Chocolate, African daisy, New Zealand liverwort. They're out there. If you have enough echinacea, I guess you need a phenomenal amount, but it's a different type of molecule. It doesn't work as well.
I'm a 63-year-old lady who lives in the West Coast, and she's got very bad Parkinson's with very bad shape down the right side, and she can't go to a restaurant with her husband and eat because her knife will fall, she just throws it all over the place. And she tried, she has a half or a quarter of a cannabis cookie, and the shape goes away totally. So what product would you recommend that she...
So if she's getting on the black market, it probably won't have very much CBD in it, so she's responding to the THC. Which product? She just needs it to work for a long period of time, so she needs some sort of oral product, either an oral oil, which is the most common administration, or in an oral capsule.
So what's the Sativex?
Sativex is going to cost her about $1,200 a month. It's a spray, it has CBD and THC in it. It gets in partially through digestion and through the GI tract, and partly through your absorption through the mouth.
So the oil she would need purchase
services? Yes, so until the bill passes and she can legally have THC, she'll be on the black market. Yeah.
No,
but it's a oh. Yeah, so the green fairies have been there, the green nurse of compassion.
Yeah, she can't.
Okay. Yeah, preacher to the choir. Good.
So where do you see this in, let's say, 5 or 10 years, like from a GP perspective, do you see people describing this commonly or?
Yeah, I do. It depends on how badly the politicians mess this up. They could do a really good job. They don't need to regulate it so much. As you see, there's not death from it. No one dies from cannabis. It's out there already in the community. Your patients are using it. By using it, they're criminals. In 5 years, I hope that there's many different products out there. We're educating everyone on how to use it. And in such, we're keeping it away from under 20s.
Well, product formulation is almost available on the market. So we've got certificates here. Others coming. When is this available?
So as soon as it's legal, we will be shipping in stuff from Canada, and depends from Burley Heads Cannabis, we'll bring in stuff from Canada, and then depends on what the government says with regard to regulation to grow. If they make it easy in New Zealand, it'll be growing in New Zealand. If they make it hard, well, we're not going to profit from it.
Peter Dunn said yesterday, just a few weeks.
Which when Peter Dunn speak means whatever. I think there's a real possibility that it could be, THC products could be legal by the end of the year. It's a possibility, but I really think the politicians are really going to mess it up. They're going to over. Technically, you could get it in now through the Ministry of Health. Technically, you can do the paperwork in the way it is, et cetera, and get it in, but you have to ship it from Canada, and you will have to incur the costs with that to get the permits, et cetera, and get it shipped across cold chain from Canada. So you've got to take your product over there and double its price at this stage. As doctors, you can apply to the Ministry of Health right now to grow cannabis for your patients. You can fill out the application and send it in. Exactly. So that's when you go downstairs and you see Chris. He's a hemp farmer, and you can ask him to grow it for you. He has a license to grow hemp and cannabis. He can use your license to grow it for you. Then he can get someone, a chemist nearby, to make up your product. Interested?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'll get you some forms. But yeah, if you're seriously though, a doctor, you can apply to the Ministry of Health to grow.
So, can we get somebody to grow it? I work for Two Boy, and I've got patients who are using cannabis, and I'm not their own bat. But if I got a Two Boy garden to grow it, is that legal?
Yes, I see no reason why. And in any application, say, I'm going to get the garden grown. I'm not sure what they might bounce back at you. What's your security measures? In Australia, land of the law manufacturer is extremely complex. You have to have a facility indoor grow, has to have two layer barriers, has to have various security, and the Office of Drug Control charge you $20,000 for the permit to grow. Plus, when they come to inspect you, they charge their rate out at $800 an hour. Plus, they said they'll put a levy on you for having the permit, and that might be about $200,000 a year. So the politicians can mess it up. Don't you worry about that. Yeah.
Seems like for this
there is seed stock out there, and unofficially, I know some people that around there that would have it. It would be lovely if we could get a whole heap of CBD stock plants out in the community. That would be fantastic. And take our street high THC cannabis and turn it into the mixture, the blend. That would be great. Yeah. From the THC side of things, some people respond to that. And there's two sides to that. One, you give a dose where they're not high, and two, a dose where they are high. And I'm sorry to say that you're already giving drugs that will alter people's state of mind. You're giving them opiates, you're giving them Lyrica, etc. And getting your head around that fact is the key process in accepting THC. Any other questions at all? Right, thank you for your attendance. Just going to see who's going to put their hand on it. There's three beers over at the stand if you like.